Jessica admitted she was in denial about her mother's death on 9/11, but she couldn't get in touch with her anger.
I don't know why I'm so overwhelmed, but I do know closure freaks me out.
What? We're just a bunch of bricks. What's the problem?
I see underwater stuff.
You see underwater stuff? Do you have a bathing suit on?
Yes.
Okay, well, bricks, underwater. What to do,
what to do.
Jessica has a lot of hidden anger about her mother's death and about 9/11, and it is stuffed deep inside of her.
I believe we're working on what step?
Grieving my mom.
Grieving your mom. And how are you feeling about that process?
I feel like I'm finally, making steps forward.
Well, one of the things that we're working on is going through the 5 stages of grief.
Right.
So what's the first stage?
Denial.
Denial. You've done a really good job
yeah.
coming through your denial. What's the second stage?
Anger.
Anger. So today what you're going to do is you're going to write on these bricks all the things you're angry at. Okay? Take the brick, and I want you to throw it in the water.
Okay.
You ready to move to this next level?
I'm really scared. I don't know why.
Because what happens when you get angry?
I lose control.
You lose control. And then when you lose control, what happens?
I haven't really let myself get to that point.
Maybe you'll feel helpless.
Yeah.
Maybe you'll feel powerless.
Right.
Okay. Maybe you'll feel inadequate. Maybe you'll feel
powerless is pretty big.
Powerless. If you allow yourself to be angry, you'd actually have to channel all your energy somewhere else.
I don't even know where to start. I'm angry that she got on the plane.
Okay.
I'm angry at my grandma for being the one that my mom went to see, even though she was mean my mom's whole life. I'm mad at my mom for being so loving that she'd go to take care of her. She had asked me if I wanted to go, and I said yes, and I changed my mind.
So it would be better if you died with her.
No, but
at least you didn't die alone.
Yeah, I'm angry that every politician used my mom's death to justify their decisions, right or wrong. I'm angry that I not only saw my mom die a violent death, and that I have to see footage of it over and over again.
And smell.
Footage, images, pictures, mm-hmm. smell. Mm-hmm. I have no control.
These past 4 years, I have walked around feeling this tension inside me, like I'm just trying to keep everything bottled in.
Mavericks. I'm just angry and I don't know what to do.
Yes.
Like there's no way for me to escape it. It's everywhere.
Yes.
She was a victim.
Yes.
People don't even give her that. They have to make her a hero. And she was a hero in the way she lived, but the way she died, like, that's not an honorable death. My mom is about, like, peace and love, not war and, like, hate.
So everything that's happened since 9/11 is nothing your mother would agree to?
Nothing.
So not only did you lose your mother and your mother's voice, in some way, you lost yours. and you suppressing your anger, do you notice where your anger is?
Bottom of a pool.
Submerged. If you wanna start facing your anger, then you have to physically go down and get those bricks and bring them up here so we can do something else with them.
I want Jessica to make a very, very important decision today. Is she really willing to expose her anger to herself and take responsibility for it? I don't want her to take the bricks out of the pool until she's good darn and ready. Because when she takes that anger out, she's gonna have to face it.
You can do it, Jessica.
I'm angry at my mom for getting on the plane. It was one of the only times she's ever flown alone, and it was to see my grandma. And I'm angry because she couldn't wait one more week to go with my dad. I'm angry at myself because I had planned on joining my mom at one point, but at the last minute decided I'd rather stay in New York with my new boyfriend and my new job. And I'm mad that she had to be on that journey alone. I'm angry that the humans can hate so much and not care who they hurt.
How's that feel?
It feels good to get them out. But now I feel like I brought them back.
You
want them gone.
All right.
Jessica's not quite through. She's retrieved the bricks, but now it's time to express herself and stop the fear of feeling powerless.
Tell me why you're picking those ones.
I'm angry that she got on the plane. I'm angry at myself for not going with her.
Own it. Yeah, there you go. What's this?
I'm mad at everybody whose first words comforting me were, "Oh, your mom died a hero's death."
What should they have said?
They should have asked about her life. If they really wanted to know my mom, they'd ask about the way she lived. And that's where they draw their inspiration. And that's where they'd honor her, not in the way she died. Out of all the emotions I've been suppressing these past 4 years, anger has definitely been the one I've denied the most. I convinced myself that the anger is not a positive feeling, and the fact that it was anger and hatred that killed my mom, it was most important for me to show everyone that I wouldn't let her death bring those feelings out in me. And to keep those feelings bottled up has really left me feeling numb and disconnected from everything.
So what have you learned about anger? Is anger something to fear?
No, just keeping it's what's scary. It's better to face it. Like, I've been happy since I've been here, but not like this. It feels different.
You mean you're changing?
Yeah, I guess so. Yeah, I don't feel guilty. Normally, I feel guilty when I feel happy.
Well, then I guess we've done our job.
Yeah, I guess we have.
All right, good work.
Thank you.